Hey, what's up, you guys? So today's video is going to be a little bit different. It's not going to be a short film or a short story. It's actually going to be a video tutorial. And if you know me in real life, you know that I have a very strange obsession with masks. But today, I'm going to try and make a mask that looks similar to the one I used in my short film, Prey. If you haven't seen that yet, please go check it out. I had a huge help from my friend Dirk from Deathlight Productions. Definitely go check his stuff out, too. It's awesome. I'll leave a link down below. But I'm going to take you through my process of how I make my stuff. If you really enjoy this video, don't be afraid to subscribe and leave a comment down below of what you think I should do to try and make the channel better and make things up a little bit more.
So with any artistic process, the first thing you want to do is always draw on an outline of what you may want. You always want to have more than just one approach to a project. That'll keep your ideas flowing and keep them more smooth. So we're going to go with this mask. So next we're going to take our clear tape and cover all the holes on the hockey mask. Next, we're going to take some hot glue and we're going to fill in those holes. Alright, so it's also important to know that evenly disperse the hot glue. Don't just press it in so that way once you smooth it out, you won't have to do much sanding. You also don't want to just press your fingers onto the hot glue. Make sure your finger is dipped in cold water before you do that. Next, peel off the tape and it's all smooth. Next, we're going to take our Dremel tool with the cutoff bit and we're going to start cutting out some holes. We're going to make the eyes wider, and we're also going to chop off a little bit of the jaw. Not too much, but we want to give it a little bit more narrow profile. Now kids, it is very important not to cut towards yourself, especially with a power tool. It is very dangerous. Take it from a professional idiot. Don't do it. Next, we're going to attach our sanding bit to our Dremel. This is going to help us smooth out the shape of the eyes a little bit faster, as well as the jaw. Now grab some sandpaper with a low grit. This is going to help give the edges a smoother finish. So with the same sander bit, you're going to roughly go over the entire surface. It's also important to get most of your big head into the shot so no one sees anything. And just grab some sandpaper and go over it again, just to give it a little bit smoother finish. Next, you're going to get a large foam mat, and you're going to trace out the shape of the nose that you want to cut out. Now just compare the size of the mask to the nose, making some last minute adjustments before we cut it out. Next, just trace the shape of the mask onto the nose so that way they fit more snugly. Next, you want to take the shape of the nose and put it on the mask so that way you can mark out where you want to put the glue. Since we're using contact cement, you definitely want to get it on the first try. If you put it on and you try taking it off, you will tear the foam trying to remove it again. Alright, so with contact cement, it's a little tricky when you're applying it. Apply two coats to both sides, let it dry for a few minutes, and you're good to go. Next, take your Dremel and smooth out the edges so that way they are flush. Next, you're going to take some spacers you cut out from the same foam, and you're going to glue them to the sides of the nose. You want to try and fill it out as much as possible, so that way you don't have to do any work later. And then sand them smooth. Next, you want to take some plumbing filler and fill in all of the cracks and crevices that you left behind when you were filling in the nose. Now, I don't show it here, but you're also, once you're done applying this layer, you're going to spray it with Plastidip. That is very important, so you can build up the layers and you get something like this. Next, grab one of the thin foams and you're going to cut out several small strips. It doesn't have to be a straight line, make them wavy and curvy as possible. You're gonna do this over and 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 over.
The blackest eyes. The devil's eyes.
You're gonna need about 100. Next, slowly start to apply the strips to the surface of the mask. It took me about 2 days to do, so good luck. Alright, so grab your handy razor pen and you're going to start carving in lines that suggest wood grain. Again, they don't have to be any particular order, you just have to try and make it look like old rotted wood. Next, you're going to grab your heat gun and put it on low. You're going to slowly apply the heat to open up the cuts that you just made and seal the foam. Once that's done, grab some Plastidip and give it a spray coat. Next, grab any color spray paint of your choosing. I personally like blue. You're gonna give it a couple coats and make sure it gets down into all those cracks so that way you can show through later once you apply the final coat of paint. Next, we're gonna give it a couple light dustings of matte black spray paint. This will ensure that the blue still comes through the cracks while the black covers most of the surface. Now at this point, I'm pretty much going to give the paint job up to you guys. I prefer more of a weathered look. I did this with dry brushing. If you guys know what dry brushing is, it's when you take a thin brush and you wipe off most of the paint, leaving it somewhat dry, and lightly going over all the cracks and crevices to give it more texture. This next part is completely optional up to you guys. I always like to take some black spandex. You're just going to cut it up into small squares, so that way it doesn't take up so much space on the mask. Next, apply the glue to the mask, so that way it gives a firm hold on the spandex. An important note, when you place the spandex down, always try to pull it tight. You don't want the eye to look too wrinkly, otherwise it'll just look stupid. That's one side done, and both sides done. And once this step is complete, you've finished your mask.
Thanks again for watching, guys. I know it was kind of a long video, but that's just the process that it takes to make something like this. If you enjoyed this video, like I said before, please like, comment, subscribe, share the heck out of this video. It really helped me out. More videos are to come, don't worry. There's a new short film that'll be coming out pretty soon. Keep an eye out for that. If you want to follow the official Zombie Apple Productions page on Facebook and Instagram, I'll leave both the links down below. Thanks for watching again, guys, and stay scary. What I want.